Chapter 1, or the introduction chapter, is an important part of research thesis and research reports. The quality of Chapter 1 and the presentation of Chapter 1 has an important role in terms of influencing the reader or the thesis examiners and supervisors with respect to the quality of the overall quality of the thesis. Although Chapter 1 is the first chapter of the thesis report or the research report, in many cases this is the chapter that is generally written or at least refined towards the end of the thesis writing process. So what is the general structure and contents of Chapter 1? These are the things that we will briefly discuss in this presentation. So first, the Chapter 1 itself has been divided into different sections, and these sections include the beginning section, which is generally called the introduction. So we can say this is introduction inside the introduction chapter. Introduction and background is the section of the Chapter 1 that is written in the beginning of the of this chapter. And the aim of this is generally to introduce the reader to the concept, the idea, or the research topic. So there is a brief background of the research topic and the general meaning and the contextual meanings of the research topic or topics that have been explored in the thesis are introduced in this section. The length of the introduction section of Chapter 1 will vary in line with the kind of research report that it is. For example, in doctoral studies, in doctoral thesis, the introduction section might be longer might consist of several pages. In shorter reports, such as, for example, master level thesis or undergrad thesis, dissertations, or in research papers, the introduction section might just be from a paragraph to a few paragraphs. But the general aim of the introduction chapter is to give a very good, precise, and concise introduction to the research thesis or to the research report. The kind of language that is used should be academic and should be grammatically correct and should catch the interest of the reader, so that the reader develops an interest in reading the entire thesis. That is why the introduction section, a well-written introduction section, is very important in terms of the success of the student or the writer to keep the interest of the reader in reading the whole thesis later on. The second part of the Chapter 1 is the problem statement. The problem statement generally is to state the problem or the issue that is being explored in the particular thesis. So the problem statement, again, it is a concise statement of the problem. Generally, it could be a paragraph or a few paragraphs. And here, the problem or the issue is presented in a more direct way and with lesser background, with focus on the problem. And this should again be something that should be presented in a way that again gets the interest of the academic interest of the reader in order to help them read the thesis further. Then the next part has certain subparts, and so here, after the problem statement, generally there should be research questions, research hypotheses, and research objectives. So generally most research theses or research problems begin with research questions. And so the questions should be presented in concise language. The research questions should be clear. The research questions are, in many cases, especially in quantitative research designs with positivistic paradigms, that can be presented in terms of research hypotheses. And then the research objectives. So generally, the research objectives represent the ways in which the researcher can respond to the research questions. So the research objectives or aims are actually to find or to explore answers to research questions, or actually to find evidence related to either accepting or rejecting the research hypotheses. So again, these are concise parts of the introduction chapter, and these are integral parts of the introduction chapter. Then the rationale and significance parts are also generally essential parts of chapter 1. Here, the research issue or problem or the research topic has been rationalized, and in the significance part especially, the importance of exploring that particular topic has been highlighted. So these sections are very important in order for the writer to indicate why they have conducted this particular study or why they want to explore this topic, and what is the importance of, also what will we get at the end of the research process, or what we have reached at the end of the research process. Then research gap analysis is also very important, and generally it's a part of the introduction chapter. So here at this stage, there is a brief gap analysis. So this could also be put towards the end of the introduction section in chapter 1, where it is analyzed that the topic has been explored in certain ways or using certain research designs, but there is need for further analysis, further exploration because of certain reasons. So here, what academic gap is being filled through this study? This is something that is explored in this part of the study. Then we also have a delimitation part in the introduction chapter. The delimitation part is generally included in quantitative studies with large samples and with the big amount of data collection. So we need to, in many cases, quantitative studies, because of the bigger sizes of populations and samples, we need to, or because of the multiple aspects of the research that we are exploring, we need to set boundaries on our research. So in the delimitation section, this is what is actually done. The boundaries of the research are actually identified. Then the operational definitions and abbreviation sections. So in many cases, we have explored social phenomena or natural phenomena, and so we need to give operational definitions of phenomena that we have explored in our research. For example, if someone is exploring the concept of intelligence or maybe academic achievement, they need to operationally define how they have actually defined intelligence or academic achievement in their particular study. And so that is why operational definitions are very important, because this process gives clarity in terms of identifying and exploring research variables. And similarly, abbreviations, because there are concepts or maybe variables that have longer names, and we need to use those in shorter, with their shorter names or acronyms or abbreviations. And So you do not want to repeat those longer names or nomenclature throughout the thesis. That is why in the beginning we give these abbreviations, so that the reader knows what these abbreviations later on mean when we use these in the remaining chapters of the thesis. And lastly, we need to, it is generally a good practice if a brief summary is given at the end, a brief summary of the whole introduction chapter, and also a general brief introduction in a few sentences of the remaining chapters of the thesis. So if that is given towards the end of the chapter one, that gives a general idea to the reader of what they are expecting to read in the remaining of the thesis. So this is a general structure of the chapter one, or the introduction chapter of the thesis. Of course, there might be variations across universities or across institutions, across different disciplines. But this is generally expected, that the introduction chapter should have these topics and subtopics.